The New York Police Department, founded in 1845, swear by law that their goal is to provide safety. They say their mission is to enhance the quality of life in accordance with constitutional rights to enforce the laws, preserve the peace, reduce fear, and provide for a safe environment.
Stop and frisk is basically when police officers stop people on the street and ask them questions and potentially frisk the people that have been stopped. I think it is something that is wrong for a number of different reasons. Last year, 700,000 people in New York City were stopped and frisked, almost all of them having done absolutely nothing wrong, and almost all of whom were people of color. Now that to me is racial profiling and has no place in the city, whether it be with police officers or anybody else.
Police misconduct is definitely a problem in New York City. We've seen numerous cases for decades and decades, not just old cases, but tons of new cases too, where police are abusing their power, abusing their privilege to be able to check people in order to not just brutalize them, but also to sexually harass them, to embarrass people in the streets, to criminalize people who are doing nothing wrong, you know, for no reason other than their race or nationality or their gender or what the police feel their sexual orientation or documentation status might be.
Police brutality is an upcoming and ongoing problem in New York City. It is commonly associated with African Americans and Latinos, but often overlooked in the Chinese community. Through this documentary, we will uncover the hidden truth.
I've heard a lot of things over the years where people feel that Asians, API communities, don't experience as much police brutality as others. And in some ways it's true, and in other ways it's not true at all. We've seen historically there's been a lot of violence against our communities, especially in undocumented communities. Where police feel that they can harass and do whatever they need to do. And a lot of times, like in certain issues, like we're dealing with a lot right now with housing issues, with evictions and whatnot, the police are used as the soldiers to get people out of their homes. And so we're seeing a lot of abuse of API communities through that, and also just harassment of people as immigrants, people, street vendors working on the streets. And also our youth are also getting harassed a lot too. It's very important to know your rights because, flat out, police will try to violate your rights by going into their pockets, violating people's rights by coming into their homes without a search warrant, by searching their cars without a warrant and without probable cause.
It was about 4 years ago when I just came here. One day, they just showed up and knocked on my door. I opened the door up, and they said something in English which I don't understand, so I shook my head. And they didn't say nothing, just came into my house and start searching or looking for something. And after a while, they just left, and I didn't know what was going on.
There's a language boundary with, like, when they talk to policemen and stuff. I think a lot of police harassment is kind of unnecessary, because they could have other people translate or whatever, but instead they usually resort to like violence or whatnot.
2009年3月份发生的事情，我到街上去买东西，到商店里，然后在我拿钱的时候，就付钱的时候，买东西付钱的时候，我钱包里面比较多的钱，这钱是我从银行里取出来的，然后还没及时寄回去其他院处。 然后黑一个非洲人看见我很多钱，就跟过来给我，我到门口钱付好，到门口非洲人就跟我说，我的钱其中300块是他的，我拿到了钱，我说不是你钱，我当时不会讲英文，然后我一直走，他一直跟，然后我也报警了，警察就把我抓起来，他很暴力的行为。 就没给我讲那个什么，就是意思不很了解的情况下，就把我逮捕关进警察局。
他讲你那无人知，他 I was actually here when it happened. Yeah, I just saw a bunch of cops round up around the police officer and they started beating him up on him. It was only a sound complaint, so I guess they could have just went up to the old man and told him to be quiet or stop playing his instrument, which he did, but then the police still kind of beat him up either way. Ever since 9/11, the police had too much power against us and we can't really do much about it because we're either going to be beaten by them or we are already oppressed by them and we're going to be oppressed by them even more. This entire country has been turned to a police state and I think it's pretty bad.
They bang at you, you bang at them. It's self-defense. Nigga, look at our condition today. What the fuck you proud of? We trapped in a vicious cycle that we can't get out of. We represent the highest percentage of AIDS cases. The federal, Supreme Court, and child support cases. We overpopulating all correctional facilities.
So I think the work that People's Justice is doing and the member orgs within People's Justice, like CAV, the work that we're doing around knowing your rights is very important as far as community empowerment. Even if you don't know, even if somebody doesn't know their own rights, if you're coming down the street and you can inform them of their rights, you know, you don't have to let them do that, or the police can't search in your car like that, you know, various things like that. It can be very empowering. And at the same time, cop watch is another tactic that People's Justice does a lot where, you know, we go on teams and we go through patrols through neighborhoods and we break out our cameras whenever we see police stopping somebody or harassing somebody. As well as oftentimes we encourage people to just in their everyday lives, whether you're on a patrol or not, whether you're with a group of people or by yourself, to pull out your camera anytime you see the police.
应该先找社区的或者找简单的律师免费律师或者帮你去争取你只要你做了对了没做坏话的事情应该去保持自己的清白应该站出来。Of course, it's very important for communities to work together. Asian Americans are a community of color, just like African Americans and Latino Americans, and we have many of the same struggles.
Making change in this land comes from uniting. It doesn't come from standing by ourselves and trying to make it happen for just our own peoples. It happens when we find our unity with other peoples who are facing issues as well and facing oppression as well, uniting and getting freedom for each other. Lastly, I think just really building a mass movement where people across the entire city and across the nation are standing up together across, you know, different boundaries that we normally have, whether it's across ethnic boundaries, racial, nationality boundaries, whether it's people with documentation or citizens standing up for the rights of the undocumented, whether it's straight people standing up for the queer communities, whether it's able-bodied people standing up for people with mental disabilities or physical disabilities, who are oftentimes we see the victims of police brutality, especially those with mental health issues. So it's important that we all stand together and stand up together and say, you know, even if it's not happening to me, I'm not going to let you do this to somebody else in my city, somebody else in another community, because whether or not it's happened to me, it's still wrong.